Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Crack That, turning problems into solutions. Today I am up with a new decision making video, and under this video we'll be talking about a different category of question named as combination of answers. Now if I just scroll down and show you the type of question I'm talking about, here in this question you would be getting five different statements, and depending upon these arguments or statements you have to find out which combination of statement would be the best suited answer for us. So we would be now going to the passage and first try to understand what the passage means and then go and solve the question. So over here, for the ones who are here for the first time, can also refer to the I button at the top, where you will be directed to the previous decision making video. Over there I have explained this same passage in very much detail. So if you want to understand this passage in detail, you can go and check out that video. And for the ones who are following the trail and coming back here after watching those videos, you would find this passage similar to the passage I took in the second part of decision making video. But here still I'll give you a small brief of what's happening. So basically NPP is a political party which is deciding the future of the two of its party members, Mr. Loyal and Mr. Prodigal. Mr. Prodigal is the son of Mr. Loyal and presently accused in a brutal murder case. So because of this case, the opposition party, the social media and the social activists are really creating a lot of criticism for the party and for the people, which is damaging the image of the party. And keeping this into mind, the party is thinking to take a decision in this case. However is a structured word, and if you find my RC related videos, then you will see that in the golden rules I have always been talking about these structured words like but, however, on the other hand, etc. These kind of words are really important in any kind of passage, not only reading comprehension but summary, critical thinking, etc. Everywhere it's important. So here when I see however, I understand that the track of the passage is changing, and now the passage is telling about the importance of Mr. Loyal to the party. He has many significant followers, considered to be an asset to the party, and therefore if you take any harsh decision against him, this could affect the future of the party and even cause a split. And so keeping these things into mind, let us jump to the newly added question in this video. In this video, we are talking about a new person who is known as Mr. Opportunist. So Mr. Opportunist is a veteran member of NPP. Now, noticing the veteran member point is very important. The reason for that is veteran in itself means quite experienced. So Mr. Opportunist has also an experience in the party, so he has some claims there. He stakes his claims to be nominated as the NPP candidate. Now, when he wants to nominate himself, he is presenting few arguments in favor of his candidature. So we will now read through the arguments and we will decide that which two arguments will best strengthen his claim. What was his claim? To be selected or nominated as an NPP candidate. So let us go through these points. Here, to save our time, we would be using the option elimination skills. That means first we will read through 1 to 5 and we will try to understand which one or two will definitely not strengthen the fact. And if that statement is present in any of the options, we can eliminate that. So reading the first statement or the first argument, Mr. Loyal's candidature in the upcoming election will adversely impact the NPP's chances. Hence, the party should not nominate it. Well, it looks quite obvious and quite correct that because of all these criticism being done in social media, we need to keep this in mind that if Mr. Loyal gets elected, like if he gets nominated, then his chances of winning can be really less. So this seems to me as a good point. Next, I come down to the second one. The party should call a press conference, disown Mr. Loyal. Now, if you go back and check the passage, which I'll do right away, and see, however, Mr. Loyal is very much an asset to the party, and any harsh decision against him can lead to split of the party as well. So disowning Mr. Loyal would be a very harsh decision against him, and this could affect the future of the party, and therefore we will never ever take this process. Now moving next, so we can understand that whenever we have 2 in any of the options, we can eliminate it. So we will never be taking option C as our answer. Now the third line, the party should not be able to take any strong disciplinary action against Mr. Loyal if he gets re-elected. Now this is something not related at all. I consider this to be not related to the present situation, because here we are talking about why should we not nominate Mr. Loyal and why should we nominate Mr. Opportunist. This is the condition we are taking a decision upon. So Mr. Loyal getting elected and then not allowing any strong disciplinary action against him is something not related to the passage. So 3 doesn't sound to me a very strong argument, but I'll not eliminate it until and unless I read the other points. So let's see. Fourth point. I have a lot of goodwill and significant followers in the constituency. Now, this is something I definitely need. A person who has a lot of goodwill and significant followers is the best candidate for the party. And of course, if Mr. Opportunist is providing this, then the party should go with him. So of course, wherever you see option 4 or statement number 4, you should consider those options. So I can see B and E are presently in my list. Now the last one says that none of my close relatives are into active politics. Now this statement basically is because Mr. Prodigal is the son of Mr. Loyal and all these issues have been created by his son Mr. Prodigal. So therefore he also mentioned this statement that his close relatives are not into politics. But do you really think that this will affect his candidature? Not really. Does it mean that he will never get into a controversy because of this reason? Again, not really. So that's why the fifth point is also a very vague point, which will never strengthen the claim mentioned by Mr. Opportunist. So if we find any option having 5 in it, we can eliminate that. Whoa, now we are left with only 2 options, 1 and 3 and 1 and 4. And just as I said that the fourth is the strongest point ever, which supports the claim of Mr. Opportunist. So therefore, we will be simply going up with option B and just confirm our answer by looking at the first line that of course we should not elect or nominate Mr. Loyal because this would affect the party's chances of winning. And fourth point, which is the most important point, that the constituency has a lot of followers of Mr. Opportunist and he has a lot of goodwill there as well. So keeping this into mind, my best possible answer would be option B, which is statement number 1 and 4, which will strengthen the claim mentioned by Mr. Opportunist. So this was another category of decision-making questions where we learned that if we have many correct answers, how can we combine and get that answer? And for the combination type questions, we should always go with option elimination, which will not only save our time, but will also give us the right answer. So if you find this video useful, please don't forget to like this video, share it with your friends, and of course, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet. I'll be up with more such videos. So until then, please take care and thanks for watching.